Hey guys, it's Lou. I'm back for another video. I wasn't planning on doing a video today, but I went to the flea market and a record store with my brother-in-law this morning and actually came back with a pretty good set of records. So here we go. The first record, it's a record that I've been looking for quite some time. I've had this record on, I've had this album on CD forever, and it's Van Morrison Moondance. And I saw this a few years ago for about 15 bucks and passed up on it for some reason. And ever since then, either I haven't seen it or I've always seen the reissue, which is upwards of $30+. So found this today in excellent condition for less than $7. Gatefold. Don't need to tell you guys about this album. This is classic Van Morrison right here. Probably my most favorite Van Morrison album. The next three records actually are by a band that I just recently got into, and I had seen some members in the VC show this band, and I started to check out some clips of some of their songs and really liked what I heard. I saw a video by Steve Whitty who showed this band. The band is Bebop Deluxe. A few other people have shown this band, and like I said, I started to listen to some clips. I kind of went into this backwards and got a live Bill Nelson record that I actually quite like a lot from 2011, where he does a lot of Bebop Deluxe songs. And today happened to find three of their records. So this is their, I believe, second album called Futurama. And also got their fourth album, Modern Music. This is great stuff. Some great guitar playing, some nice alt rock kind of feel to it. All these records, I believe, are from about 1975 to 1979. And the third album of theirs that I found, really happy to find these, Drastic Plastic. I've only heard the first one a little bit, but from what I understand, Drastic Plastic is a little bit different sounding than the other two, maybe a little bit more new wave-ish in sound, but that's fine for me. And I've shown Cream before, Eric Clapton, Jack Bruce, so I'm a big fan, and today I found this record. It's credited to Jack Bruce and Friends. The Friends being Billy Cobham from Mahavishnu Orchestra, David Sanchez, another well-known fusion player, and a guy named Clem Clemson, who I don't know. Maybe you guys out there know who he is. He's on guitar. This album, as you can maybe tell from how they're dressed, is from 1980. It's a decent record. I was hoping for it to be a little bit more jazz fusion, and it has elements of that, but it also has some 80s elements in there, so it's not exactly what I expected, but it's still a decent listen, and that's what I got playing in the background right now, just trying to get into it. Jack Bruce and Friends. The name of the album is I've Always Wanted to Do This. Sticking with the 80s, we have an 80s classic from Duran Duran and their album Rio. Of course, Hungry Like the Wolf, Save a Prayer, title track is on this. My wife had some Duran Duran stuff, Seven in the Ragged Tiger, Arena, but funny enough, she didn't have Rio. So when I saw this today, I thought next time I see Rio, I'm going to have to grab it. Again, sticking with the 80s, a band that I think was more popular in the early 70s from out of the UK, Slade. This album has two big hit singles that I really enjoyed back in the early 80s, Run Runaway and My Oh My. The name of this album is Keep Your Hands Off My Power Supply. So those were the only two songs that I really knew. And since I really liked them, and I thought I'd take a chance on this and see what the rest of the stuff sounds like. I've only played one side of this so far, and everything kind of sounds like those songs. I think this one's a keeper. Next, an album that I'm not that familiar with. I used to have the download of it, didn't really play it a lot, but I've seen some members in the VC show this, and apparently is a, you know, quite the classic from back, I think, 1968. The Crazy World of Arthur Brown. Admittedly, I don't know this album very well. I've just played the first side so far, and I like what I hear, but I know this is sort of a classic album that's mentioned in psych circles. So when I saw it today, you know, I couldn't pass it up. The next album, of course, being in Canada, you know, Rush is one of our greatest bands that this country's ever produced. And, you know, there's fans of Rush across the entire world. But in Canada, you know, they're a special band. And I've got quite a bit of Rush vinyl, mainly from the 70s and some of the early 80s. I think up until about Grace Under Pressure that I've got. And, you know, CDs and cassettes and things like that. I have most of their 70s output, but one album I didn't have was A Farewell to Kings. This album, I'm not quite sure the year, I think it's around 76, 77. Admittedly, I'm not the biggest fan of the song Closer to the Heart. I know that's the big song off of this album. I'm much more of a fan of the song Xanadu, which is on this album and is one of my favorite Rush songs. But anytime you can get Rush for less than $10, I think you gotta jump on it. And we have a super group, The Highwaymen. Of course, this is Waylon Jennings, Willie Nelson, Johnny Cash, and Kris Kristofferson. This was their debut album. I have the title track, The Highwaymen. Big River is on here, a couple other well-known tracks. Found a really good copy of this one today, and I've had this on CD for quite a while now, so I'm quite familiar with this album, and I've got a lot of Johnny Cash in my collection, some Willie Nelson, some Waylon Jennings, some Kris Kristofferson, mainly Johnny Cash, but love this album. And another icon, we have Bob Dylan and his album from the 80s, Street Legal. I saw someone show this recently and saying a lot of good things about it. I think it was, I'm not sure who it was, but they were kind of saying that this was their favorite 80s Bob Dylan album. So when I saw it today, I jumped on it. And yeah, anytime you can get Dylan for less than $10, I think is a pretty good deal. And showed an album earlier, the Jack Bruce album, was hoping to be a little bit more fusion, because I showed some fusion recently, some of my Mahavishnu Orchestra albums that I've purchased recently on vinyl. And the last Mahavishnu Orchestra album I showed features Jean-Luc Ponty. And Andre at I think his channel is called Reluctant Collector. He made a comment about how Jean-Luc Ponty is one of his favorite musicians, and I made a comment back saying, you know, I've got some Jean-Luc Ponty on CD, but I don't have any of his solo stuff on vinyl. That is until today. We have Imaginary Voyage. So I don't know this album very well. I think I have the Enigmatic Ocean on CD. But I figured I enjoyed his playing on the Mahavishnu Orchestra album. I'm sure I'll like this album. And last but not least, and continuing with the fusion, we have one of my favorite fusion artists, Pat Metheny and the Pat Metheny Group. I've got quite a few Pat Metheny on vinyl. Most of the stuff is from the late 70s, early 80s. This album is a double live album called Travels. I think it was recorded in Norway, if I'm not mistaken. And this is an incredible, incredible album. I found this today. It's in great shape, not only the vinyl, but the sleeve as well. And I would highly recommend this to anybody who's trying to get into fusion and is finding maybe Mahavishnu Orchestra and bands like that maybe a little bit too out there and too experimental. This is fusion that I think is much more accessible to people who may not be completely into jazz and jazz fusion. This is an incredible album. Has fusion elements. It has some new agey and world elements to it. Definitely Pat Metheny's guitar playing is outstanding on this, and Lyle Mays, who's the other main member of the Pat Metheny group on keyboards and piano, is also excellent on this, and this is highly recommended. Okay, guys, that's it. Thanks a lot for watching, and again, I invite your comments. All right, see you around.